In the heart of ancient Greece, a legendary tale of heroism and labyrinthine challenge unfolds. Join me as we journey into the depths of the myth of Theseus and the Minotaur, a story steeped in mystery, courage, and sacrifice. Our story begins on the prosperous island of Crete, ruled by the powerful king Minos. Known for his cunning and ambition, Minos held great favor with the gods. In a grand display of divine favor, Poseidon offered Minos a magnificent bull, pure white and strong, a gift meant to be sacrificed to the gods in a grand ceremony. But this bull was unlike any other. It was of such extraordinary quality and beauty that King Minos couldn't bear to part with it. Instead, he chose to keep this magnificent creature for himself, offering another bull as a sacrifice to the gods. Poseidon, angered by Minos's choice, vowed to punish him for his arrogance and betrayal. In his divine wrath, Poseidon set the wheels of vengeance in motion, a curse that would shroud King Minos's lineage in darkness. As a result of Poseidon's curse, King Minos's wife, Queen Persephone, was afflicted by an uncontrollable and forbidden passion, an insatiable love for the sacred bull, the very same bull meant for sacrifice. Driven by her forbidden desire, Queen Persephone sought the help of the ingenious craftsman Daedalus, who constructed a remarkable contraption, an intricate wooden cow, a lifelike mimicry of a cow's form. Inside this wooden cow, Queen Persephone concealed herself and lured the sacred bull. Their union led to the birth of an abominable creature, the Minotaur, a monstrous hybrid of man and bull, cursed by its very existence. With the birth of the Minotaur, a gruesome truth came to light. The Minotaur possessed an insatiable appetite for human flesh, making it a terror that struck fear into the hearts of all. King Minos knew that he had to contain this abomination. Thus, he turned to Daedalus, the ingenious craftsman, to design a labyrinth, a maze of unparalleled complexity meant to be a prison for the Minotaur. Within the labyrinth's twisted corridors, King Minos imprisoned the Minotaur, sealing it away from the world. There it would remain, a terror lurking in the dark, awaiting its next victim. To quell the Minotaur's hunger for human flesh, King Minos demanded a tribute from Athens. Every 9 years, 7 youths and 7 maidens were sent to face the labyrinth's treacherous depths, a fate feared by all. When the time came for Athens to send its next tribute to Crete, a courageous and noble figure stepped forward. Theseus, the son of King Aegeus of Athens, offered himself willingly to be a part of the dreaded tribute. Born to royalty and destined for greatness, Theseus saw this challenge not as a burden, but as an opportunity to prove his worth and put an end to the horrors of the Minotaur. In the heart of Crete, Theseus met Ariadne, daughter of King Minos. Her heart, kindled by Theseus's courage and noble spirit, ignited with a love that defied all boundaries, a love destined to change their fates forever. As their love blossomed, Ariadne, inspired by the ingenious craftsman Daedalus, devised a practical plan to aid Theseus in the labyrinth. She provided him with a slender thread, a lifeline to guide him through the maze's treacherous twists and turns, ensuring he would not be lost in the darkness. As Theseus descended into the labyrinth's inky abyss, he clung to Ariadne's thread, unwinding it slowly. Each step brought him closer to the Minotaur, his heart filled with determination and dread. At the labyrinth's heart, Theseus confronted the Minotaur, the fearsome beast born of tragedy. With valor and resolve, they engaged in a fateful battle that would decide the fate of all. Theseus emerged victorious, having vanquished the Minotaur. The curse that had plagued Crete for so long was finally broken. Guided by Ariadne's thread, he retraced his steps, emerging from the labyrinth's darkness into the light of day, a triumphant hero. With the Minotaur defeated and the curse lifted, Theseus and Ariadne's love had blossomed amidst the trials of Crete. But destiny had different plans for them. They departed Crete, their hearts intertwined. Their love, forged in the heart of darkness, promised new adventures and a future beyond the labyrinth. Yet in the twists of fate, Theseus abandoned Ariadne on the island of Naxos. There, abandoned and alone, she caught the eye of Dionysus, the god of wine and revelry. Dionysus and Ariadne found love, their union blessed by the gods. She became his bride, but this is another story. Thank you for joining us on this epic journey through the myth of Theseus and the Minotaur. Much like Theseus himself, may you find courage and strength to face your own labyrinthine challenges. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more mythological adventures. Until next time, stay curious.